Hi, my name is Jeff Staub. I'm the application engineering manager for Danfoss, and today I'm here to talk to you about the new Danfoss TU thermostatic ice machine kit. It's a universal replacement kit that we offer for ice machines for the contractors and wholesalers for an easy retrofit for ice machines that are out in the field. So now we've pulled out the unit, we've gone around to the back side of it to identify the ice production output capacity. You want to look at the label on the back. So you want to look at the manufacturer's label and the model number and the serial number. And what you're going to do is just look up the model number that you see on the back of it. If you have apps that can scan the barcodes, just scan the barcode. And typically, if you were to Google just this model number, as I punch in the model number into the phone, and I do a Google search onto it, I can actually see in the first two search items that comes up, it says ice machine, half size ice machine, cube 336 pounds. So I know that the total production output for this device is 336 pounds. So when I go to select the units or the actual ice kits from the TU valves, I can see that there's two separate valves. One of them is sized from 75 to 600 pounds for a cuber, and the other one is from 351 to 1800 pounds for a cuber. You also have sizes on here for a flaker as well. So these two valves will cover all of the ranges of ice machines, whether it's a flaker or a cuber, for all 404A applications. So as we open up that valve, it's a kit. You can see the selection on the side of the ice capacity right on the label. You open up the kit, and the kit contains a couple different items. You'll see some copper fittings. This is just to ensure from the equipment manufacturers, they use both an angle way or a straight through configuration valve. Some of them use quarter inch inlet fittings, some use 3/8 inlet. On the outlet, some use 3/8 and some use 1/2 inch. So these copper fittings are there as a universal kit, so you can make an adapter fitting from the valve to the copper that's in the system. And then of course inside, we have a couple different parts. You have the valve, a separate box for the valve. You have your three different orifices, and then of course you have your sensing bulb, your thermostatic expansion valve sensing bulb insulation to be able to insulate that to your suction line. So again, let's open up the instructions, and you can see the basis for the selection. Of course, it's important to read all of the instructions, but really, when you're looking at the sizing of it, your small and your large configuration, and then you can select the cuber and the nugget and the capacity. So right here, we dial in and look right at the 150 to 350 pounds for a cuber. We have a 336 pound ice machine. We come across and we're going to use the number three orifice. So there's some other instructions down below, how you do the valve assembly, how you put the orifice inside of the valve, how you tighten it down, and then of course some general brazing instructions, as well as how you install the copper strap for the bulb to the suction line, as well as the superheat adjustment. So we know that we need a number three orifice for the valve. As we open up our side panel for the ice machine, we can identify the capillary tube. We can see where the TXV is sitting, and we can also see where the bulb is sitting inside of there. So first we have to do a little bit of prep work. We need to pull all of the refrigerant. We need to reclaim all of the refrigerant out of the system. We need to pull the insulation off of the thermostatic expansion valve. And then after we pulled the refrigerant out of it, we pulled all this insulation, now we're ready to start the prep work and the installation of the new kit. Prior to removing it though, you want to do a best fit. So once again, you open up your kit that you have on top of the machine. You have your bag of your copper connectors. And what you want to do is you want to just size up what the connectors are here. So on the inlet, we have a 1/4 inch fitting, and on the outlet, we have a 3/8 inch fitting. So we'll open up our bag of fittings, put in the appropriate fittings into the inlet and the outlet by the valve. You can see on the side, there's a direction between the liquid and the suction line for the appropriate direction to put it in. And here what we're going to do is, you're just gonna try and do a mock-up. So as you do a dry fit and look at where you're going to cut this. There's two ways to pull a thermostatic valve out of the system. You can either cut them out or you can torch them out. Use a torch to braze them out. Advantages and disadvantages. For certain, many times a torch is very quick to do. However, you have to be careful when you torch it out. If you want to send that back to the manufacturer, for an evaluation of the valve. If you torch it out and you overheat the valve, you can cause additional damage to the valve, and the manufacturer may not know what the true root cause failure of it is. So typically, you're always safer to cut it out of the system, and you usually have, because the original valve is brazed right up to the valve, where now we're putting two couplings or two fittings on either side of the valve, so we have an additional difference or an additional length that we'll be able to use. So we just mark it up on the outside, mark your pipe with a Sharpie or a pencil, and then start making your cuts at that joint. So now we've just taken, we've removed the insulation, and we've just cut this valve out. So we have two, both copper stubs on the end of it. We've just taken some sandpaper, cleaned the ends of these up, and now I'd say we're ready to install the next one. Again, the purpose of this video is to show you the general replacement of a thermostatic expansion valve. I recognize that the system is now fully exposed and opened up. So proper techniques would be to replace the filter dryer, the liquid line filter dryer at this point. I'm not going to go through that process for the sake of this video. So we have our new valve. Prior to doing any brazing, you can do a dry fit onto the valve. Make sure your couplings are fitting okay out of your bag. You know, just kind of twist the valve on. So once we have a dry fit and we're sure that everything's going to fit okay, our next step is going to be to put the orifice inside of the valve. So pull off your bottom cap of the valve, and this is where your orifice is going to screw right into the bottom of it. We have an orifice. There's three different orifices inside of the box. You can see it's a TU1, a TU3, or a TU5. For this selection, I've chosen the TU3 orifice. So I'm just going to slide the orifice out of the plastic cartridge, and that's where your center orifice. So you have a built-in filter around it's a screen around the inlet orifice of the valve. So we'll screw this into the valve. I'll put a little bit of refrigerant oil onto the threads so it threads into the bottom of the valve nice and easy. So I just poured a small bit of polyester oil into a small cap, and now I'm just going to put that right around the threads of this so I get a nice easy screw-in of that orifice. Plug it right into the bottom and then thread it down, and it screws right in. Again, this is the important part for reading the instructions, as you can see here. It says in the instructions, right here, torque it to 19 to 22 foot-pounds. So we've got the valve fitting. Just below, we've put an additional fitting on a Schrader valve. And up on top of the ice machine, we've connected our nitrogen line, so we have nitrogen flowing through it. Now we're ready to start brazing the valve. One of the unique benefits of the Danfoss TU valve is the inside of this connector, although it looks like it's completely stainless steel, it's a bimetal connector. So you have the stainless steel on the outside, which doesn't transfer heat, or it has a very low thermal conductivity, so no heat is transferred to the body. So you don't need to wet wrap the valve. You can just put your torch right onto it, raise it in, and you're not gonna damage the valve. So we don't need to wet wrap the valve. We do have nitrogen flowing through it, so, and it is a quick, easy installation. So we have both the outer joints of our couplings and the joint at the valve itself that we're going to braze in. So normal process, we'll use a standard 6% brazing rod. Start up our torch and braze it in. Okay, so we start heating the inlet connection. Again, heat it up. You'll see the stainless starts to glow pretty quickly. You'll get that connector nice and hot. And then you'll just drip your rod right around there and do an install. Again, be careful of the capillary tube and any wires that are hanging inside of the valve. See, of course, you're burning up some additional insulation, getting it bright red. And then you can see it's the valve's brazed in, so it's a very quick braze. That's the extent of it. And here again, the interesting thing, we didn't wet wrap it. I can touch the top of this valve. I'm not burning my fingers up, so there is a little bit of heat onto it. There's no doubt about that. But we didn't burn up the valve. And now, as always, you still need to cool it down. So that heat is transferring down the copper pipes. And you can, of course, see some of the insulation that's smoldering. So, of course, our copper got the bright red there. So we need to cool that off. So you can see the steam coming off of those lines. We don't want to burn up or melt any wires that are close to them. So, and that's pretty much it for the replacement of the Danfoss Universal TU ice kit. So we'll cool it off. Next step here, we're going to pull our nitrogen off of it. Once this fully cools down, we're going to re-insulate all of the thermostatic expansion valve. And we do have to mount the bulb. Take your strap that comes inside of the kit. Here's a brand new copper strap for the kits. Now, based off of the thermostatic expansion valve, I would recommend using the new strap that's associated with this valve. It's a fully copper strap which transfers the heat from your suction line directly into the bulb. So here again, when you put this in, you're just going to wrap the bulb strap around the bulb and the suction line. You want to make sure that this is completely unscrewed. You just wrap the strap around both the bulb and the suction line, put the two in here, and then you're going to screw down the strap. It goes deep inside of this. It's a little bit more difficult to see to get it in, but you'll mount the bulb on the top portion of your suction line, typically in the same position that the previous bulb was located, and you're just going to mount that and strap it down. And that's all that you need to do. And now next step would be to remove your nitrogen lines, pull an evacuation down below your 500 microns, and then you're safe to charge the system again. So as you can see here, we've put the stainless steel bulb mounted onto the suction line. We've attached it with the copper clamp. When you look at the remaining amount of capillary tube, it's okay to leave it dangling. However, one of the things, some people like to wire tie it up. Rather than just wire tie it to anything, make sure you don't wire tie it up to your hot gas line. So that can give you improper operation of the TXV. So here's the final installation. All we're going to do now is just insulate the tubes and we're ready to operate and have it up and running. Again, so that's the installation procedures. Again, from Danfoss, there are two single thermostatic expansion valve kits, both with three orifices, the insulation and instructions, and they cover the complete range of flakers from 75 to 950 and from 500 to 2300 pounds, and your cubers from 75 to 600 pounds and from 351 to 1800 pounds. So two valves, you can keep it on your truck and you're ready to address any thermostatic expansion valve failure on any ice machine that's out in the field. Thanks.